Let's quickly go through that. Let me share my screen for you. Yeah, can you see my screen? Okay, so I gave you assignments on module 3. Now, did you see this? When you go through the site, you realize that I have this here. There's a file before you join. Have you seen this one? Timetable 1 to 10. Now, I want all of you to download that, okay? Now, make sure you have this. Just download it. You can print it out. Now, as part of this course, I want you guys to learn this very well, okay? So, you should be able to know 1 times 1 up to 10. That is the only thing you need to know. 2 times 2, you need to know up to 10, back and front. 3 times 3, you need to know up to 10, back and front. Okay, when we ask you, it should come naturally. You need to know 4 times 4, up to 10. Everything that you see here, up to 10. You don't need to go further. So you can see here from 1 to 10, 1 to 10. So this is the chart. I want all of you to download this, okay? Then study this. These are the basics. You need to know this one. Okay, so download it and learn this one back and front, okay? If I ask you 8 times 8, you should be able to know it, okay? These are the basics to help you do all your robotic maths easy, okay? You can do the calculation for this, but you don't need these ones to do calculation on this. So make sure you have this chart, all of you, and learn it. Next week, I will ask all of you. I will make sure the chart is empty. All this place will be empty. And then we do simple mental here first. So make sure all of you, you've downloaded this chart. Okay. Now, here you can see we have the module 3, the assignment I gave you. Okay, you can see this question. I say you solve problems in your head. Now, did you try this? The test 3, did you try that? Okay, so we will take 10 minutes to practice that here. I want to know if you really did that. Okay, now all that we are doing here is to use your mind to solve this multiplication problem that we have here. Let's say when I say 12 times 15, you should be able to do the calculation and give me the answer. But how can you do that in your head? So you realize that the 13 is for us to work in our head, okay? So with this one, the first point that you need to know from this, here we are saying that solve Okay, so let's continue. So now we have here, solve problems in your head. Now the question is, when you use these strategies, you will be able to solve any kind of question that you've been given, especially multiplication, and then you are supposed to calculate of any number, should be able to do that. So for example, we have 16 times 16. If I ask you 16 times 16, how will you solve that in your head? And these are the strategies which I have put them down there for you to. So the first thing is, you have 16 plus 16, okay? And I believe you understand this point, okay? Now, 16 times 16, in your head, you already know that we have 16, which is 16 times 16. Okay, so with this, you already know that you are drawing your diagonal, your circle up. So you already know that this one, you are going to draw it up. Okay. So this is the explanation of what this means. So once you have this, you know that you are dealing with this 10. So this one is in your head. So now here is what? 6 plus 6. So now you can see here, because you are dealing with up, okay? You are dealing with up. When you do a simple multiplication, this one is up, so you add your plus to this, you add your plus also to this. Okay, so now we are adding 6 to the 16. So that's why you see here the first thing you add in your head, because you already know this, so you don't need to go through all this process. So 16 plus 6. Okay, so from the second, you should be able to know it's 22. Now, how do you do that? Always, I'll tell you that when you have a single digit here, just add the six to the six, because 16 by 16, they are all the same. So you just take part of one, okay? So which is 6 plus 6 will give you 12. When you add this, which is all 10, already 1 is here, so make it to 22. Okay, so that is what we mean here, because we know that all is the same. So you start from 16 plus 6, then you add 22, okay, times your 10, so times 10, which will give you 220. So Do you understand that? So that is this point. Now, 6 times 6 is equal to 36. Now, you know that once you've gotten this part, you know that 6 times your 6 is what? 36. Now, to add this, to make it simple for you, you can just decide to, you know, 36 is the same as 36 is also the same as 36 is the same as 30 plus 6. Because you want it to be easy for you, Then you just add your 30 to this, which gives you, so 30 plus 250 plus your 6, then you get your answer. Okay, because you are using your head. So just take away, put the 6 down, add this 1 to this. Then you are supposed to receive your answer, which is what? 250 plus your 6. Okay, so in other way, what you are seeing here is 36. Like this here, we are saying that you can also go by this, because you know that 36 is the same as 30 plus 6. So you can do your 30 plus 30, which will give you 250. Plus your 6. So now you are adding to the last digit, which will be 256. And that is the answer. Okay. That is the answer. So we want to try something. Let's see if someone can actually do that, use the same principle for us. Okay, so let me do that and see if someone can actually use the same principle for us. So I have a number here that I want you to use your mind to calculate it for us. Okay, so yes, can you hear me? Now, wait. Okay, so now wait. This is what I'm saying. If you don't understand, pay attention. Okay. I gave you assignment to do. Okay. And I asked you that, were you able to do it? Were you able to do test yourself 3? Were you able to do it? Now, who did that? Who did text yourself 3? I want to know who did that. Who was able to do that? Text yourself 3. Text yourself 3. Just raise your hand. Let me see. Okay. Those that were able to do it. Text yourself 3. Who did that? We have test yourself 1 and 2. Then the test yourself 3. Who did that? Okay, no one. It means no one tried the test yourself 3, right? Okay. So since you couldn't do that, I'm just explaining it to you. Okay. Now, this is what we are doing in test yourself 3. Now we want to use our mind to solve this. Let's say we have this question here. Okay, 12 times 15. Okay, if this question has been given to you to solve, okay, who can do that for me? In your head, we have 12 times 15. Who can do that for us? In your head. So 12 times 15. First thing is, you know that this one is above 10. Okay? It's above 10. Okay, so you know that we are going up. Okay, so this, definitely you know that we are dealing with what? 2 and 5. Okay, which is plus, and this one is what? Plus 2. Right? Okay, here we know that we are dealing with 10. Right? Now, when you want to do a simple app Okay, now this is 2, this is 5. So what can we do here? If I'm multiplying this by this, you already know that the top you get what? 10. Now let's come to this. But because it's plus, diagonal, you add what? 2 to this, you add 5 to this. So any other way, you can decide to only choose 1. Not necessarily to put all this thing. In your head, you can decide to go by 2. Okay? Or you can decide to go by 5. Because you know that this is 12, this is 5. And then, what number will I need to add to 2, 10? That will give me 12. It's 2. Yeah. Hello. Hello. Yeah, can you hear me? Okay. So I believe this point you understand, right? So what we are saying is to use your mind to solve this. What you have to do is, first thing is, you can pick any of this number. Okay. I can decide to, if I'm going to use 12. Okay. You know that this one is going with this. Okay. So, or this one is going with this diagonal, which we already talked about. Okay. So 2 is for 15 and then 5 is for 12. So if I'm going to use 2, then I'm going with 15. So what I will do is I can say here that 15 in my head, 15 plus 2 in your head, okay, which will be 17, right? Times 10, which will give you 170 in your head, okay? Once you get the 170, you come to the top, okay? So, which is this time, this will give you what? 10, right? 2 times 5 is 10, okay? So, you know that is what? Plus 10 in your head. So you just add it to the 70. Okay, so I know that I have my 1 there. Then I'll add my 10 to this, which will give me 80. Do you understand? So in your head, you can do this calculation because you don't need to do all, you just pick one part because this and this is the same. If I'm going to use this diagonal, so it means that I can say 12 in my head. I can say 12 plus 5, which is equal to 17. Okay. Now I'm dealing with what? 10. So my 0 here, I have 70. Then I have to add the multiplying the top, which is also 10. So plus 10, which gives me 180. Do you understand? Hello? Yeah, so that's what we are saying in your head. Okay, because when you want to do mental, so now let's pick this one. 13 times 14. I want to do this in my head. Now, first thing, I know that 13 and 14 is above 10. Because I'm picking 10, it's above 10. So it means that I'm going to add positive. So in my head, I know that I need 3 to add to 10 to get to 13. I need 4 to add to what? 10 to get to 14. Diagonally, 4 is going with what? 13. So I'll do like this. Okay, so we are doing this again, so pay attention. Okay, so I'm picking the other number here, which I have 13, okay, times 14, right? I know definitely I'm dealing with up, so plus 3 will be here, So you can, I can register this in my head. I don't need to write it. I know plus 4 is also here. Diagonally, this one is going here. So in my head, I know 4 is going with 13. Okay, the basics that I'm using is what? 10. So in my head, I will say 13 plus 4. Okay, which will give me 17. Okay, times my 10, because I'm dealing with the 10, so 0 here. Then I'll come to the top, which is what? 3 times 4 will give me what? 12. So plus my 12. If it will be difficult for me, I can add 10. Always we try to make it easy for you. So I will say 10 plus 10 plus 2, which you know that is the same as 12. Okay, so which means plus 10 will give me what? 180. 180 plus 2 will give me 182. Okay, simple, because you try to break 10 down in your head so that you can add. Always try to pick 10. 10 is use the number that you can easily add. So you just do so that you always find it easy to add. So if the same way, if you decide to pick 14 to start with, because you know that 14 goes with 3. So in other way, you start with what? 14 plus 3. So 14 plus 3 equals to 17. In any way, you should get the same answer times your number that you are working with, the base, which is 10. Okay, which will give you 170. Then you know the top is what? 12. So plus your 12. If you already know the answer, you can add. But to make it easy for you, which is 10 plus your 2, which is the same as 10. 12. So which will give you 180 plus 2, which will give you what? Sorry, 180 plus 2, which will give you the answer as 182. Do you understand now? Hello? Okay, so we can do this. Okay, thank you. So we can do this thing ourselves, okay? So that is the part 3 that I gave you. Now you do this in your head. Okay, we don't want to write them down. That is not the essence. Writing them down, we want to know that we really understand what we are doing. We want to train our mind to do calculation. That is how the reason why we are doing the robotic mathematics. So now I don't need to remember my multiplication timetable over and over. To make it easy for you, that's why I'm giving you the chart. So the basics, like 4 times 4 and all those things, you don't need to break down to waste your time. So if you know those ones, it makes your work very easy. Okay, so if I have this one, 12 times 18, who can do that for us? In your head, 12 times 18. Okay, do that for us. 12 times 18. So you start with So let me tell you this. The reason why I was writing, because I really want you to understand. Now everything should be in your head. Okay, so first thing, I'll just ask myself this question. 12 times 18, okay. 12 is above what? 10, okay. How many is that? 2, okay. So it means that my top is plus 2. Here I'll have for plus 8, okay. Diagonally, 2 is going with 18 and 8 is going with 12. So I will start here and say maybe 8, 18 plus 2 in my head, which will give me 20. Okay, which will give me 20. Then I know that my top, I was dealing with what? 2 and what? 8. Okay, 2 times. Do you understand? Hello? Yeah, do you understand what I mean? Okay, so what we are saying is, now you already know this. Okay, so diagonally, you are dealing with these two numbers, which you have invisible. Let me say this one is invisible. You are not writing it. In your head, it's there. You have plus 2 here in your head. Okay, this one 2 is in your head. Okay, plus 8 is also in your head. Okay, you are not writing. I say use your mind to do. So you know that diagonal, this one is going here. So you know that if I'm picking this, I'm going to add this one to this. Okay, so here I'm going to receive what, 20. Okay, then I know that I'm dealing with 10. Okay, so times 10 will give me 200. So in my head, I will start, okay, 12 times 18, 12, 18 plus 2, okay, times 2, 200, like we are calculating 200, then 2 times 8 is what, 16, which will be plus what, 10 plus what, 6, which will give you 210 plus my 6 will give me 216. So in your head, you give the answer. 12 times 18 is your 216. Because you already have this picture in there. You don't need to write this one down. The 10, you are not writing it down. So you pick the easy number that you can go with. If you think that this place is okay with you, with 12 and 8, you pick that. Do you understand? Hello. Okay, so I want someone to try 12 times 6. Who can do that for us? 12 times 6 in your head. 12 times 16, sorry. 12 times 16. Who can do that for us? Okay. I'm listening. Twelve times sixteen. So how are you starting it? You already know that these numbers are above 4. First thing, that's why you need to ask your first thing. Is this number above 10, the basics that you are picking? If yes, you know that you are dealing with positive. Okay. So you know that you are having 2 plus 2 and plus 6 up. Okay. You know that 2 is going to, the one above this is going with the 16. 6 is going with this. So you can decide to go. So when we are starting, I was expecting you to start with 16, okay, plus 2. Or you can start with 12 plus 6. Okay, which you know that the answer will give you what, 18 here. The answer will give you what? 18 here. Okay, then you know that you are dealing with 10. So you add your 0 here. You add your 0 here, which is what? 180. You can either choose any one. Then you multiply the 2 because 2 times your 6 that you have here, which will give you 12. And the 12, you break it down. It will be what? In your head, 10 and what? 2. So that you can easily add them. So 10 plus this, you get 10 plus this is what? 190. Okay. Plus your 2, which will give you 192. Okay. When you pick this one, it will be the same thing. Okay. It's the same thing because the 12 here, you are getting the same. Okay. So, in any how you solve it, you are supposed to get the same answer. So if I pick to work with 12 and add the diagonal to it, I'll get the same answer. If I decide to pick from 16 plus this, I'm supposed to get the same answer. Okay, so in your head, you are not going to write as we used to social work. Here, you are supposed to use your mind to solve it fast for me. Do you understand? Hello. Okay, who can try that? Let me give you. Do you understand? Do you all understand now? Who doesn't understand? Okay. Okay. Let me see the one who is not getting it. Let me see. Raise your hand. Let me see. Who is the one? Hello. I want to see the one who is not getting it. Rosalind. Okay. Rosalind, now pay attention. I'm going over. Okay. Last time, pay attention. Okay. I won't repeat it again. So now, you've been given this question, okay, to solve. Now, you are supposed to use your mind to do this work for me. Okay. 12 times 14. Rosalind, listen to me. 12 times 14. Okay. From our previous class, we show work. Now, this time, we say we should use our mind to solve this. So, in your mind, your base that you are know that you are dealing with 10. So, 10, this is above 10, what? 2. So, you know that top here, you are having this one in your head, invisible. You are not writing it. It's in your head. You know that here will be plus 2. Here is also plus what? 4. Okay, in your head. Okay, you know that it means that 2 plus 10 will give you 12. 4 plus 10 will give you what? 14. So this one's supposed to be in your head. Okay, now diagonally, you know that this 2 will go with 14. This 4 will go with what? 12. Okay, so to solve this work, I can decide to go with pick the 12 or pick what? The 14. So if mentally you are asked, use your mind to solve this question, I'll start from 12. Maybe I want to go with 12. So 12 plus 4 in my head. Okay, I'll ask myself, 12 plus 4 will give me 16. So I know here is 1. Another way is 1. So it means that 4 plus 2 is 6. So I write my 1 and I write my 6. Okay. Then I know that I'm dealing with 10. So I'll multiply by 10, which is I'll add my 0. So I know I have 160. Now, this 160, now I know that I'm dealing with plus 2 and plus 4. So I will multiply this. So this plus this times this will give me what? 2 times 4 is 8, right? So plus 8. So which will give me 168. So I know that 12 times 14 is 168. Do you understand? Now, I'm saying that you can also go by 14 if that is what you want. So in other way, you start with 14 plus 2, which is also going to give you 16 times your 10, 0 here. Okay, then you do the same thing to this. Multiplying the top is also 8. So your answer will be 168. Do you understand? Are you okay now? Okay. So using your mind, I don't expect you to write this one. This one should be outside. I expect you to start from here. So I know that you are, so the work that I gave you, if I'm saying you should use your mind, I was expecting something like this, to know that you are using your mind to solve this thing for me. Okay, so let's try this. I want someone to solve this for us. This time I won't talk. I'm writing the question down. I'll call. Okay. 15 times 15. Is Franklin here? Franklin. Hello. Okay, Franklin, solve this for me. Use your mind. 15 times 15. I'm listening. So who agree with Franklin? Do you agree with Franklin? Who? Okay. So what do you think? What's supposed to be the way? Your version? We are listening to you. Yeah, I'm asking you that, do you agree with Franklin? If not, tell us your view. Do you agree? Do you agree with Franklin? Do you agree with? Okay, so what me? I don't agree with Franklin. And the reason being, I'm saying that you should use your mind. Okay. So what I was, Franklin, you've done well. Okay. What you did is okay. But where I'm not in agreement with you is I want you to go straight forward. Okay. You don't need to talk about the... this is what I'm saying. Using your mind is you have to practice first. Okay. So once you are done, but I'm saying that if you are using your mind and you want to send it to me, this is what I'm expecting. Like you are having this 15 times 15. I can start with 15. Okay. Plus 5. Because I already know in my mind that it will be plus 5 plus 5. So I don't need to write them down up here. You don't need this part. Okay? This one, you should know it by heart. The moment you see it, you should know that you are dealing with this. Then you know that here is what? 10. Okay? So you are going to get what? 20. 20. Plus your what times your 10 will give you your 200. Okay, that is the part. So answer is what? 5. What you have 5. Here is 5. It's not 2. So 5 times 5 is what? 25. So plus what? 25. Okay, 25. Plus this will give you 225 is the answer. So this is what I'm expecting if you are using your mind. You don't need to go here and write all those things here. Because in your mind, you know that. Yeah. Now we are using 10. You know the reference number you are using is 10. Okay. For now, because we've not done maybe a different reference number. What we've started is we've done the reference number 10 and the reference number 100, right? So those above 100 and below 100 and done below 10 and above 10. And then what we were taught from our previous class is when it's above 10, we write it up, which means plus. When it's below the reference number, we write them down, which is what we introduce what minus. Okay, so I know that by now you understand all those principles. Okay, do you understand? Yeah, so we go straight. So Franklin, what we did, I was expecting this. Okay, yeah. Yeah. What? Now, okay. Now test yourself too. You realize that we are dealing with what? 87 times what? 86, right? Which is what? Below what? The reference number what? 100. Do you understand? Yeah. So I was expecting that. Let's try that. But do you understand the first what you've done here? Test yourself one. Do you understand it? Okay. So right now, I want someone to do this for me. 12 times 18. Who can do that? Yeah, like what I've done right now. 12 times 18. Who want to try? Okay. Okay, try. Benson. Benson, 12 times 18. 12 times 18. Benson, in your head, 12 times 18. Yeah, is Benson ready? Yeah, hello. What? Times 18. Yeah. So how do you get the answer? I want you to do like what I did, so that I know you understand it. You are not using calculator, so that's what I want to know. So what's the process? Like how I started mine. Let me ask, who can try again? 12 times 18. Boom. Okay, we go next. Is we go next? Hello. Yeah, okay, try. Twelve times 18. So what will be the process? Now let's do this. Okay, this one is simple. Okay, this is what I'm saying. 12 times 18. So simply you start with, you can go with what, 18, or you can go with 12. So you can start with 18 plus 2, because you know that 2 will be here because it's 10, so plus 2. So definitely know that 18 plus this will give me 20, because you know here will be plus 2, here will be plus 8. I want to go with what, 18 and 2. Okay, well, yeah. I'll just explain it to you, but I want you to get this. Do you understand? Hello. Hello, do you understand? Yeah. Okay, it's the module 3 that I'm explaining to you. Okay, so it's the same. Okay, so just when we are done, you can complete the assignment I give. Okay, so once you have this 18, so you know that 18 times 12 times 18 will be what? 18 plus 2, or you can pick this. You can pick this 12 plus what? 8. Do you understand? Why are we having 12 plus 8? Who can explain that? Why? Why? Okay. So that's good. So the reason being that you know that we are dealing with our reference number what? 10. Do you understand that? Do you understand that? Hello? Hello? we are dealing with our reference number what? 10. And you know that 10 plus what will be what? 10 plus 2 will give us what? 10 plus 2 will give us what? 12. The same thing is what? 10 plus what? 8 will also give us what? 18. But then when we are solving it, we deal with what? Diagonal. So you can put this thing in your head. Okay, so if here is 12, I know definitely 2 will be up. So I can add the 2 and the 18. So that's why I'm doing it. So I don't need to do this thing again. Okay, if I here is 12 and here is 18, and I want to use the 12, I know that 12 plus what? 8. Okay, do you understand that point? Which will also give me 20. So this is what I want you to do, you guys. Then I know that the reference number is what? 10. So times my 10 here will give me this. Will give me this 200. Okay. 2 times this is what? 16. So which means that here I'm having 10 plus what? 6. Because I'm doing that so that it will be easy for me. So this plus this will be what? 110. Like this, 116. Okay, so I have my what? 216. Okay, this is what I'm expecting from you. Okay, so you guys take this, take note of this, okay, and then practice it. Okay, now let's finish with the last one I gave is what? 87 times what? 86. Okay, when you have this, you are supposed to multiply this. So in your head, you are supposed to know that this one you are dealing with what? Below what? Your reference number, which is what? 100. So it means that here is going to be what? Minus what? Minus what? What will be the answer? No. What number will you add to this? It's what? 13. So, is it 13 or 20? It's 13. 13, right? Other one will be 14. So, here will be minus. Okay, so this is in this one should be registered in your head. Okay, so now if you have this, you are supposed to go by diagonal. So it means that you are adding, if I'm going to subtract, to be 87 minus 14. Okay, so if I'm subtracting 87 minus 14, definitely you can decide to break it down, because here will be difficult for you. Another way to write 14 can be what? 10 minus 10 minus what? 4. Okay, so if you subtract 10 from what? 87 will give you what? You can do this thing in your head. Okay, so you are going to get what? 77. Okay, 77. Then minus 4 will give you what? 73. So you know that here will be 73 in your head, because always you write this one. Then you multiply by your 100. So now you are going to have this. Okay. Okay. So now you come back to this side. Now you see here, this is where the challenge sometimes is, but here can also be broken down. Do you understand? If you already know our previous class that you've done, yeah, you can use module 2 to solve this. Okay, so we have for 13 times what? 14. Okay, you realize that you can break this one two down. Okay, so it can also go with what? 10. Are you getting me? So we can decide to break this one down, and then you have your what? You know that here will be plus 3. Okay. Because this number is huge, so solving the here will be plus 3, here will be plus 4. So that it will be easy for you. Okay, so now when I have this one, I know that this one is going here. This one is also what? So if I'm going to solve this part, I will start from 13 because I want to use the 4. So 13, okay, plus what? 4 equals to, what will be the answer? 17, right? So 17 times your 10, which will give 70. Okay, so I have my 70 here. Then I'll multiply 3 by this. Okay, 3 times 4 is what? 3 times 4 is going to be 12. So plus, okay, 10. Let's do 10 plus what? 2. So that it will be easy for us. Okay, so this plus this, I'm going to 180, 182, right? So now here, you can come here and add this one. 7, 3, this. Okay, 7,300 plus what? 182 can be breaking down into a plus what? 100. Okay, plus what? 80. Something like you make it, want it to be easy for you. Okay, plus what? 2. If that is what will be easy for you, because you are not going to do this in your head. Okay, you are using your mind. So here, if I add this one, I know that I'm dealing with the 300. Always know that this one, so I'm going to get 7,400 because you know that this is 3. Then I know that this is 80. So I'm dealing with here. So I'm going to get 7,8 what? 0. Right? Then plus what? 2. So now the answer will be 7,8 what? 2. Do you understand? Hello? Do you get it? Okay, so it's easy. So you can break it down and solve any, how big the number is, you can break them down and just put them together and then you receive your answer. Okay, so no matter how the number is big. Okay, so now let's move on to I hope we spend a lot of time here. So now we have all this one here. You can solve them for me. Okay, just try, exercise your mind. It's very important to do that. Okay, so now this is the question that I threw to you. That's what I've explained to you. You can see them down there. When you take your time and go through, you see that everything is here is the same. Which one? Which one? No, the 3 is the 3 you are not doing. The 3 is it's like a note to you. Okay, so 3 you are not answering any question. Okay, so you go through the 3 and the 4, the answer is that the question is 4. Okay, so using the principle in test what? Test yourself 3. Okay, solve, test yourself what? 1 and test yourself 2 in your head. So test yourself 3 is just a note. The three is just a note. Okay, so do you understand? The note is what I've explained to you today. Okay, now you use the principle to solve for what? Test yourself what? 1 and test yourself 2 in your head. like what we are doing. Are you okay now? Okay, so, okay, thank God that you've gotten that, okay? So, I know our time is fast spent. Let's see, I can just brush through module 4 for you. Okay, it's better you really get the understanding before I can add. So now let's move on to quick one, module 4. Okay, now for module 4, please, can you see the screen? Let me, is it okay? Is it okay? Okay. Okay, so module 4, multiplying above and below the reference number. Okay, so until now we have multiplied numbers that were both below the reference number and both above the reference number. How do you multiply numbers when a number is above the reference number? Okay, and below the reference number. So numbers above the reference and below. Example, we have this, numbers above and below. So you will see how this works by multiplying this number 97 times 125. So here we will use 100 as our reference number. So now you can see your 100 is here. So I'm having 77 times 125. Okay. Okay. So 97 is below the reference number. Okay. So this 97 that you see here is below what? The reference number. Right. Now, so we put the circle what below, which you already know. So you can see here, you put our circle what below. Okay. Now we have to go back. 125 is also above. So we put the circle what above. So you can see here plus what? Because 25 plus 100 will give us 125. Do you understand? Then here, 97, which means negative 3 minus what? So when we are having this 1, 2, when we subtract this from this, that is negative 3 from 100 also give us what? 97. Do you understand this point? Hello. 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 Yeah, are you here with me? Do you understand this point? Yeah, I want to know if you really understand where you've got into. You don't? Okay. Okay, so now what I'm saying is, okay, thank you. Okay, so what, listen, if you know, sir, listen, please, no, listen. What I'm saying is, now, the question is, we want to solve numbers below the reference numbers and above the reference numbers. So a question has been given to us, and this is the question. Is we should solve 97 times 125. Okay, how do we do that? Now we know that our reference number is what? 100. Okay, so you ask yourself, this side is 97 below the reference number or above the reference number? It's below the reference number, right? So with what difference? The difference is what? 3. So it means that 3 minus what? 100 will give me what? 97. So I'll draw my circle down. Okay. Now, when I have here 125, it's above my reference number. So this case, I'll draw my circle what? Up. So plus what? 25. Do you understand? Okay. So I will leave you here. Okay. So I won't go forward too much. Okay. So because our time is fast, okay, but I just want you to explain this one. So next time when we meet, it will be easy for us. Okay. So this one that you see here, we are done with this. So now to solve this, how do we compute this? Okay, so this is what we are saying. 125 is 100 plus 25. So we put a plus sign in front of what? The 25. Okay, and 97 is 100 minus 3. Okay, so we put a minus sign in front of what? The 3, like what you are seeing here. Okay, so now we now calculate the crossways. Okay, either 97 plus 25. Okay, you can go by this 97 plus 25 or 125 minus 3. So any other way you want to go. So I can do this or go by this. Now you know this from our previous class, what you've just done. So if I'm going by that, so I have 125 minus 3 is 122. Okay. If I subtract this, I'll receive what? 122. Okay. Do you understand? This minus this will give me 122. Okay. After the equal sign. Okay. Like here. After the equal sign. Okay. Now we now multiply 122 by what? The reference number, which is what? 100. Okay. So 122 times 100 is what? 12,200. Okay. So multiply any number by 100. We simply put two zeros after the numbers because you know that one is yes, one times any number is the same number. So you just put the zeros in front. Okay. Do you understand that? So this is similar to what we have done in earlier class. Okay. Okay. So if you go down here, this is how the problem looked so far. So we have 97 times 125. Okay. Which means that this one, the reference number is 100. So 97 is below our reference number. So we write 100 minus 3, which is 97. Down 125 can also be written as 100 plus 25, which is this. So now you can choose either way, the crossway. So if you go by this or this, so by this means that we are going to subtract 3 from 125, which will give you 122, times your reference number will give you 12200. If you are going by this way, it means that you are going to add 97 plus 25. But always, we try to use the easy way out. When we are solving this, the easy way that you can do the subtraction, this one is easier than this. So we go by this. Okay, if you are going by this, mean this plus this is going to be 12, and then when you take this side, is the easy. Okay, so now if I'm going by this, you can see that my number is here. Okay, so now this is how our problem look like. Okay, so multiplying the size. Now we multiply the numbers in the circle. Okay, so we have 3 times 25 is 75. Okay, but that is not really the problem. Okay, we have to multiply 25 by minus 3. The answer is minus 70 what? 5. Do you understand? Yeah, because this one is positive, this one is what? Negative. So when you multiply negative by what? Positive, the answer will be what? Negative. Do you understand? So now here we will be having okay, now listen to this point. Okay, now we are having 97, okay, times 125. Okay, then you know the reference number we are using is what? 100. Okay, so if you are using 100, you look at this number 95. Is 97 below the reference number or above the reference number? Hello? Below. And you know when we are going below, we use negative, okay? So you know that in other way, 100 minus 3 will give us what? 97. That's how we got this one. Do you agree with me here? Now we come to 125. So 125 is also, is what? Is it above or below the reference number? Okay, it's above. So you can see it's what? It's above 25. So now our circle will go up. So here will be what? Plus 25. Do you agree with me here too? Okay, so now we have... So now that we have this, we can choose the diagonal like what we already know from our previous class. So now I can go, this one will go with this. Okay, this one will go with this. Do you understand? So diagonally, negative 3 will go with this. So here we're going to be 125 minus 3 will give us what? 122. Do you agree? Now, if you are going with this, here 2 will be what? 97 plus what? 25. Okay. If you also do the same thing, you are also going to receive the same answer. Okay. In other way, I always used to tell you that you can just break it down. It can be 20 plus what? 5. Okay, which means that 20 plus 90 will give me what? 110, right? Then I'll add this one. 7 plus 5 is 12, which will also give me what? 122. Okay, so in other way, it's the same. So always you use the easy way. So you can realize that minus this is easier than this. So I'll pick this one. Okay, so now I'll write my answer here. Now, our reference number is what? 100. So, now 100 times 122 will be what? Always, because it 1 times any number is the same number. So, you just pick the 0 and add it to this. Okay, so now we are going to get here 12,200. Do you agree with me here? Okay, so now that we've gotten this part, the other thing that we need to talk about is what? We multiply the circle. That's what we already know. We have to multiply the circle. Okay, so with the circle part, we are having 25, sorry. We are having plus 20. Okay, times what? Minus what? 3. And you already know that minus 3 will definitely going to give us what? The answer is going to be a negative. Do you agree? Yeah. So if this time this is going to be what? 15, right? Okay. Right? 3 times 5 is what? 5, right? Remember what? 1 in your head. Then 3 times 2 is what? 3 times 2 is 6 plus your 1 is what? 7. Okay, but you know that it's going to be a negative. Okay, so now, hello. Yeah, do you understand? Okay, so now that's why we got the answer here. So now we are going to subtract negative 475 from this. So 2 from this, we can use the shortcut. So what is the shortcut for subtraction? Let's look at the shortcut. A shortcut for subtraction, okay? Let's take a break from this problem for a moment to have a look at a shortcut for subtraction we are doing, okay? So now we have, what is the easy way to subtract 75? Okay, what is the easy? Let me ask another question. What is the easiest way to take 9 from 63 in your head? What is the easy way to take 9 from 63? What is the easy way? So I'm sure you got the right answer, but how did you get it? Okay, some would take 3 from what? 63 to get what? 60. Then take another 6, okay, to make what? 9, and they will have the answer, okay, as what? 54. Some will also take away 10, okay, so 10 minus 63 will give us what? 53, okay. Then you will add 1. Why? Because this one is what? Less, so you add 1 back to get our what? 54. Okay, but I always admonish you to use what? 10. Okay, so when you use 10, it makes the work easy for you. Okay, so now let's come back to our problem, what we are having here. So most people find it easy way to subtract 9 is to take away 10 and then add 1. Okay, so the easy way is what? Take away 10 from the number and you add back 1. Okay, the easy way to subtract 8 is also take away what? 10 and add back 2. Now, we use this principle for only when you are dealing with what? A number which is what? Above the number is 1 or below what? 2. Okay, so if you are having the difference is maybe 7, is the same, you take away 10, you add 3, you are going to suffer, okay? So when you are dealing with something 9, something 8, you can add 10 and subtract back 2 or 1, okay? Now let's go to this. What is the easy way to take 90 from a number? Now, takes 100 and give back 10. Okay, so what is the easiest way to take 80 from a number? The same thing, take 100 and give back what? 20. Okay, what is the easy way to take 70 from a number? Take 100 and give back what? 30. Okay, so now let's look at this. If I got back to the problem we are working on, how do we take 75 from 12,200? We can take away 100, okay? So 100 and give back what? 25, okay? And this is the easy way. Let's try it out, okay? So I have this 12,200 minus 100. So 12,100 will be my answer, okay? Plus 25, okay? So 12,100 plus 25. So let's go back to our answer. This will be the answer. Is it difficult? Okay, so this is how we solve questions. Maths is about looking at the easy way out. That's what we are learning. So if you are subtracting a number, a big number, just look at the easy way out that you can do back and you add back the difference. That's what we are seeing here. Okay, so we are done with module 4. Okay, so I will put this question down for you to try for me. So module 4, try answers will be this. So I want you to solve this question for me. So you can see that I have 98 times 145. I have 98 times 125. 95 by 120. 96 times 125. Okay. No, you try this one. Just solve it as we were doing this. Okay. If something I want you to use your mind, I will tell you. This one, I want you to do this so I know that you really understand the principle that I've taught you to do. Okay, so I'll put the question there for you to solve for me. Okay, thank you very much. If you have any question, you can ask. If there's no question, then you've done well today. You saw at least we spent so much time here today, more than 1 hour. Congratulations. Thank you very much for paying attention to all that we've done today. But please, I want you to go and try them, okay? Try your hands on all that we have done today, okay? If you have any question, you can let me know, okay? Okay, thank you and take care. Bye. Bye.